Video 2.2, Basics of Face API. In this video, we will cover the following topics: Face service and the Face APIs, Face detection using Face API, Face verification using Face API, available SDK support. So let's start with learning what the Face service is and how Face API can be used. The Azure Face service is a collection of AI algorithms that can detect, recognize, and analyze human faces in images. We all have used Facebook and Instagram, so let's recall a feature common to both of these apps. While posting a picture with our friends or family, as soon as we upload a picture, the app and website automatically detects faces in the image with a rectangular box around each face and then gives us an option to tag each face with a person's Facebook ID. This is where Face service comes into picture. Facebook and Instagram have an underlying face detection code that does the job. So if you want to integrate such a feature in our own app, then we don't need to write an ML code and train a model, but instead use the Azure Face service by just giving a Face API call in our code, and the rest is taken care of by Azure. Facial recognition software is used across different fields such as security, mobile apps, natural user interface, image content analysis and management, and robotics. Now that we have got a rough idea about the Face service, let's look at some of the Face APIs that serve as building blocks of this service. Face detection. Detect API is used to perform face detection in images. The Detect API detects human faces in an image and returns rectangular coordinates of their locations. It does so by analyzing the face landmarks in an image. These are a set of easy-to-find points on a face, such as the pupils or the tip of the nose. There are 27 predefined landmark points by default. The coordinates of these points are returned in units of pixels. Additionally, face detection can also extract a series of face-related attributes such as gender, age, emotions, poses, facial hair, masks, smile intensity, and whether or not the person is wearing glasses. These attributes are general predictions, but not the actual classifications. Up to 64 different faces can be returned per image, making this API very powerful. But the more faces it is detecting, the more time it takes for detection, especially while extracting additional attributes. Face verification. The Verify API builds on detection and answers the question, do these two images resemble the same person? The face verification endpoint also lets us verify if both the faces belong to the same person or whether a face image belongs to a specific person. This is a very useful tool for identifying a user and provides a personalized experience. But the results are not always accurate, like in the case of comparing twins or similar-looking faces. The API returns a similarity score between both the faces called confidence. We can use this to set a cutoff point for verification, say 80%, which lets the API know that if both the images get a similarity score of above or equal to 80%, then return true, which means the faces are of the same person, else return false, and that means the faces are different. But you will need to think about the level of confidence that is acceptable in your scenario. There are other face APIs like the Identify API, Find Similar API, and the Group API. The Identify API also builds on detection and does the job of matching a detected face to a pre-enrolled face in a database. Let's say you own a company and you maintain a database of your employees' personal information. So to authorize a person to enter your company, you can take a picture of the person. Use the Identify API to check with your database if the image actually matches with any of your employees. The Find Similar API performs a face matching between the target face and a set of faces, finding a smaller set of faces that look similar to the target face. Imagine you have just found an old childhood picture of yours with some of your friends. You might not even remember the names of all of them, but looking at their faces after such a long time brings back some good old memories. In a similar manner, Find API does a face search by image. The returned images might not be the same person but with similar looking people. The Group API is used to divide a set of unknown faces into several groups based on their similarity. As with all the cognitive services resources, developers who use the Face service must be aware of all the SDKs that Azure provides. The Face client library can be used across these programming language platforms: C#, JavaScript, Python, Go, REST API. The wide support for many programming languages out of the box is to make it easier to access for developers who work across various platforms. Different applications require different programming languages, like mobile app development uses Java, while AI and ML applications require Python. We use the respective languages SDKs to integrate face services into our applications. In this course, I will use the Python SDK to implement these Azure Cognitive Services, as Python is a simple-to-understand language and it is widely used across the AI and ML applications. Video summary. In this video, we have covered the following topics: face service and the face APIs, face detection using face API, face verification using face API, available SDK support. In the next video, we will learn about the Azure face detection model.